My name is Scott Tingle. I'm an astronaut. I knew my life was going to have something to do with aviation and space from an early age. My memory is 10 years old when I made a decision that I was going to try to be an astronaut. I went and learned how to do metal fabrication. I learned how to weld. I learned how to use the mill. I learned how to fix cars. I learned how to do a lot of different things with lots of tools and lots of systems that had to work right. They actually allowed people to come in to the Navy, work for a few months, get your training done, and then go back to school full time. I didn't know a whole lot about Purdue. And when I looked at it, I was like, this is a really good school. They've got a lot of people, a lot of great programs, and look at the qualifications of all these professors and all these projects that are working. This is really cool. And then I got my acceptance letter into grad school. I just couldn't believe that this big, huge school was so one-on-one that they wanted to talk to me on the phone and make sure all my things were right and all my plans were right. And they're like, no problem, that's great. Where are you living? I was like, I don't know yet. But I had a van. I figured I'd just live in my van until I figured it out. So after my van broke down, I had to walk. And so this is the I walked to school uphill both ways story. Down the hill, over the river, back up the hill to school. And that's about 6 or 7 in the morning because, you know, you get started early as a grad student. And then when you're done, I used to do my homework down in my little office in the basement of mechanical engineering with all my friends. They had the lasers down there and they were doing flow measurements. And it was a geeky place. I loved it. It was absolutely wonderful. And all we needed was the vending machine that was down in the end of the hall. I lived on Twinkies and Snickers for a couple years and it powered my way through graduate school. Then about 10 o'clock or 11 o'clock at night, I'd walk back to the apartment and I'd get about 4 or 5 hours of sleep and then do it again the next day. I've always said that going to Purdue was the single best professional decision that I've ever made in my life. It follows me to this day. I'm 52 years old. I made that decision when I was 21. Really have some really strong relationships from folks at Purdue right now. I had no idea how to get to the big leagues in engineering. I was just following my heart, following my dreams. Do I want to go on for a PhD? Or do I want to go fly airplanes? And I said, you know, this is crazy. I need to just go fly airplanes. So I applied 4 or 5 times to the astronaut corps. The first time I was kind of figured it was a little bit early. Put in the second application. They sent out some feelers and that was about it. Put in my third application and got a couple of calls. I thought I was going to get an interview, but didn't quite happen. And then on my fourth application, I was 40 something years old. I didn't even update my application and it had been 2 years. But I'm gonna go to my grave knowing that I tried as hard as I could. And so I put in the envelope and I sent it off. And I got an interview and I came down and I ended up getting hired. So it was kind of a Hail Mary for me. So I'm lucky to be here. I'm very, very humble, very honored. I had to start all over again. And without a doubt, coming to be an astronaut is starting over again. So we have 2 years of basic training, and that includes all the systems that you're seeing in the background here with the space station. And we learned how to do EVAs, so spacewalk training in the pool. We learned how to talk Russian, which is very important because we're going to be flying in the Russian Soyuz. We learned how to do robotics. We learned space station systems and emergencies. And there's really nothing that I stay up at night worrying about. I have been wanting to fly in space all of my life, and this is a very happy moment to be able to achieve that dream. I'm really looking forward to be able to just tap the wall and go the whole length of the space station and just watch everything float by. It's going to be so cool that that's probably all I'll do for the first couple days until the flight director yells at me to start getting some work done. Engineering, in my opinion, everybody should know. It's how cars work, it's how houses work, it's how our body works, it's how things work, and how we get from here to there, and there being 5 years in the future, 10 years in the future. Engineering is the future.